Assalamu alaikum. Hi dear students, it's me Afzal. First of all, I hope you all are safe and secure at your home. From previous class, we had studied how to change the poem to prose. First, we have to bring verb, then subject and object. Fi'il, fa'il, maf'ul. After that, I had given you a homework. For example, I had shown you the first line of the poem. Once more, I am going to say that. Please listen. Bilma'i ya atfalu nulallifil ajsam. From this line, which word we want to bring at first? Verb. Which word is verb in this sentence? Nunallifu. Isn't it? Nunallifu. Second, subject. Then, object. So I am going to write that one. Nunallifu. Nunallifu. That's verb. Nunallifu. What's the meaning? Nunallifu. We clean. So we clean. Next, we brought verb. Next, subject. In this verb, subject also included. What's the meaning this one? Nunallifu, we clean. So that's we. That's subject. That's in Arabic, nu. That's subject. So, nunallifu, we clean. In this verb also, subject included. Okay? Nunallifu, we clean. Subject and verb. Next one, object. Which word is object? Al-ajsam. We clean what? Al-ajsam. Al-ajsam. We clean bodies. Verb, then subject, then object. By using what? Water. Bil-ma'u. Bil-ma'i. Bil-ma'i. Nunallifu. We clean bodies. Body with water. Verb, subject and object. Now clear? The remaining lines also we are doing by using water. That's why we use it at first. Bihi. What's the meaning bihi? This bihi is connecting to this word. To this word. Bilma. Bihi is connecting to this word. What's the meaning? Bilma. What's the meaning? With water. Okay. Bilmai with water. The remaining things we can bring like this. Okay. Second line. Naghsil thiyaba. That's poem. So which one, which word is first verb? So which word is verb in this line? Naghsilu. Naghsilu. Verb. So what is subject? Subjective. Naghsilu, what's the meaning? Naghsilu, we wash. So that's we. We means na. That's subject also included in this verb. Next, naghsilu, object. Which word is object? Athiyab. 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 Okay. Next. Next one. Which word is verb? Which word is verb? What's the meaning? Wa. And. So next, which word is verb? Next line, netbahu. 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 That's verb. In this verb also included subject. Netbahu means what's meaning? We prepare. We prepare. That's we subject. Next one, object. What is object? We prepare what? At'am. Food. At'am. At'am. Next, from next line, which word is verb, which word is object? Find out first. Neski. Neski means? Neski, what's the meaning? Neski, we watered. We watered. Neski, we watered. So, we is the subject. In this verb, subject also included. Next one, vaneski. We watered what? Az-zuhur. Az-zuhur means flowers. Zuhur. Flowers. Verb and subject and objective. Next is Watashrabul An'am. Which word is verb, which word is object, which word is subject? Watashrabul An'am. Tashrabu means drink. Who drink? Al An'am, cattle. What? Al Ma'a. So, from this sentence, which word is verb, which word is subject, and which word is object? Tashrabu. That's verb. First, you have to bring that one. Tashrabu. Tashrabu. Next, subject word. Who drink? Al An'am. Al An'am. An'am. Al An'am. Al An'am. Subject. Who? Cattle. What? Al Ma'a. Atashrabul An'ama. So, no need of Ma, no need of writing Ma, because already we wrote that at first. No need of writing that. Atashrabu, verb, was drink. Who? Al An'am. An'am means cattle. The next word is object. Object is already we told here. Okay? Next. One next from next sentence, which word is verb, which word is object? Which word is verb? Nagsilu. Nagsilu means what's meaning we studied first. We wash. Nagsilu. We wash. So, first verb. Where is subject? Subject. We wash. So, we is the subject. That's mean in Arabic, na. Okay. Nagsilu. Thia. Nagsilu. Next one. Object. Where is object? Al-Aidi. 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 Okay. Verb, subject and object. ID means hands. Hands. Nagsilu, we, nagsilu, and we wash al-ID hands. From next, vanamsahul jibah. Vanamsahul jibah means from next sentence, which word is verb, which word is object, which word is subject. Vanamsahu. Vanamsahu means, vanamsahu, we wipe out, we wipe. We wipe. Nam, so we wipe. So verb and subject also included. We. Okay, that's subject. Next, what's object? Nam, so what? We wipe what? Al jibahu, foreheads. Al jibahu. Nam, so verb and subject. Al jibahu, object. Next one. Wana kumilul wuluha wana mlili swalat. Which word is verb? Which word is subject and object? Nakmilu. Nakmilu is the verb. Nakmilu. What's the meaning? Nakmilu. Wa. Nakmilu. Nakmilu. Nakmilu means we complete. We complete. Which word is verb? Complete. That's we. What that one? Subject. Nakmilu. We complete. Next one. Object is needed. No. Object what? Object what? Al-wulu. We complete al-wulu. Al-wulu. Wulu means, that's in English, ablution. We complete ablution. For what? For what? That also mentioned in this sentence. For what? Lissalat. For prayer. Lissalat. Lissalati. For prayer. Wanakmilu. We complete subject, verb and subject. Next, al-wulu. Ablution. That's object. Lissalati. For what? For prayer. Next line, Alhamdulillahi, Alhamdulillahi wa shukurilillahi. We can say totally, Alhamdulillahi, Alhamdu wa shukurilillahi. Alhamdu, 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 Lillah, Alhamdu wa shukuru, wa shukurilillahi. Alhamdu wa shukurilillahi. Alhamdu wa shukurillah. All praise, all thanks to Allah. These are the prose of this poem. I think you did well. Please check it whether you wrote correct or not. Very important. Once more, I am going to read. Nunallifil ajsama bil ma'i bihi naghsilu athiyaba. الثياب ونطبخ الطعام ونسقي الزهور وتشرب الأنعام ونغسل الأيدي ونمسح الجباه ونكمل الوضوء للصلاة الحمد الحمد والشكر لله. Okay, now we completed how to change the poem to prose. Next activity, 12th page, you can see Najmaul Manlumatu Ad-Du'a'iyya wa Naktubuha fi Daftar. Najmaul means Najma'u. Najmaul means let us collect. Al-Manlumat, Manlumat means poem. Ad-Du'a'iyya, Du'a'iyya means Du'a'iyya means prayer. Wa Naktubuha fi Daftar and write in the notebook. Total meaning, let us collect the prayer poem, let us collect a prayer poem and write in your notebook and write it in the notebook. So now we studied a poem including prayer to Allah. Like that one prayer you had to find out from previous class textbook, from anywhere you can take it, find out and write in your notebook. That should be prayer poem. Okay, not only poem, a prayer poem is needed. You have to find out and write it in your notebook. That's your homework. Before next class, you have to complete it and write in your notebook. Once more, I am going to read. Najmaul Manlumati Ad-Du'a'iyya wa Naktubuha fi Daftar. Total meaning, please just note it. Let us collect a prayer poem and write it in your notebook. Okay, next activity. Naktashifu al-abiyat allati tadullu ala al-ibarat al-atiya. Naktashifu al-abiyat allati tadullu ala al-ibarat al-atiya. The meaning, let us find out. Naktashifu means let us find out. Al-abiyat, abiyat means poem. Allati tadullu ala al-ibarat al-atiya, to the following sentence. So, right, let us find out suitable line from poem. Let us find out a suitable line from poem to these following sentence. Let us find out a suitable line from poem to these following sentence. You can see the four sentence. I am going to read that one. We studied that meaning also. After telling that meanings, you can find out easily a suitable poem's line to these following sentence. Okay? Are you ready? Okay. Ilahi, first one. Ilahi la tatrudini min rahmatik wa laysa li raja'un illa fika. What's the meaning? Ilahi. Ilahi means, oh God, la tatrudini min rahmatik. La tatrudini, we studied that one. You don't keep me away. You don't keep me away. Min rahmatik, from where? From your kindness. Walaysa li rajaun illa fika. I don't have any hope except him. You already said this. You wrote the meaning also. The total meaning, once more I am going to say. Ilahi la tatrudini min rahmatik. You don't, Allah, you don't keep me away from your kindness. وَلَيْسَ لِي رَجَاءٌ إِلَّا فِيكَ. I don't have any hope except him. Which line is suitable to this sentence? Can you find out? We can look. Take the poem. You don't keep me away from your kindness. I don't have any hope except him. Look, sixth line. Sixth line, you can see the same word is there. Ilahi fala taqta raja'i wala tuzi fu'adi fali fi saybi judika mat'amu. That's suitable line. Okay, please just note it in that sentence, in front of that sentence. Sixth line. Sixth line. Sixth line is the suitable line from poem. Okay, you just note it. Sixth line. Next one. Ba kad kasurat dhunubi faghfir li annaka wasi'ur rahmah. Kad kasurat dhunubi faghfir li. Allah, my sins are increased. Kad kasurat dhunubi, my sins are increased. Faghfir li, please forgive me. Allah, please forgive me. Li annaka wasi'ur rahmah. Li annaka wasi'ur rahmah, because you, Wasi Rahma, you are very merciful. Once more, kad kasratu dhunubi, my sins are increased. Faghfirli, please forgive me. Li annaka wasi'ur rahma, because you are very merciful. Which line, which poem line is suitable to this sentence? Can you find out? Let us look. Third line, just look there. Ilahi la in jallat wa jammat, same word also repeated in this poem. La in jallat wa jammat khati'ati. So we can find out easily. So third line. Okay, you just write in front of that sentence. Third line is the suitable line. Okay, next. Jim, ilahi anta alladhi tasma'u du'a al-khafiyya. Ilahi, what's meaning? Oh my God, anta alladhi tasma'u du'a al-khafiyya. Anta alladhi tasma'u du'a al-khafiyya. You hear me. When? What you hear me? My hidden prayers. Total meaning, ilahi anta alladhi tasma'u du'a al-khafiyya. You hear my hidden prayer. Ilahi anta alladhi tasma'u du'a al-khafiyya. Ilahi, you hear me, my hidden prayers. Which line is suitable to this sentence? Can you find out from poem? Yeah. Look. Which line? وَأَنْتَ مُنَاجَاتِ الْخَفِيَّةَ تَسْمَعُ. Fifth line, you just look. Fifth line, second part. وَأَنْتَ مُنَاجَاتِ الْخَفِيَّةَ تَسْمَعُ. The same meaning. You just put it there. Fifth line, second part. The same meaning is mentioned. Next. إِلَهِ أَخَافُ مِنْ عَذَابِكَ اللَّهُمَ أَجِرْنِي مِنَ النَّارِ. Ilahi, oh my God, akhafu min adabik. I am afraid of your punishment. Allahumma ajirni minan nar. Allahumma, oh Allah, please protect me from your hell. Okay? Ilahi, Allah, I am afraid of your punishment. Allah ajirni minan nar. Allah, please protect me from your hell. Which line is suitable to this sentence? Which line? The last line. We studied now. In ilahi ajirni min adabika, Allah, please save me from your punishment. Asirun dhalilun, because I am a sinner. Khaifun laka akhlahu, I am afraid of your punishment. So that's eighth line, second part. Khaifun laka asirun khaifun. Eighth line, that's enough. Eighth line is the suitable to this sentence. You got it? Okay, once more I am going to say that our sentence suitable line from poem. First, sixth line. Second, third line. Third, fifth line. Fourth, eighth line. Now clear? Now, we complete first chapter and exercise also. Let us start second chapter. Ad-darasu thani. Before that, you don't forget your homework, the seventh one. You just note it. Najmul Malumat Ad-Du'aiyya wa Naktubaha fi Daftar. Page number 12th. Okay. Let us start second chapter. Ad-darasu thani. Second chapter. A'ti munfikan khalafa. A'ti munfikan khalafa. A'ti means, please give munfikan khalafa. Munfikan khalafa means freely and continuously. Total meaning, you can write a'ti munfikan khalafa. Give freely and continuously. Okay. You can see there are some pictures. First picture. What do you see in this picture? First picture. Say what? An old man, he's walking with his two sons. First, one son, he's saying what? We can read. Aruzzu hik akilna kathirun ya abi. Alhamdulillah wa alayna an nishkura Allah ala ni'amihi. Let us discuss meaning. Aruzu hakilna kathirun. Aruzu hakilna kathirun. Aruzu means what? Haruzu? Rice. Rice. Hakilna. Hakil means field. Field. Hakilna? Field. There one field and more rice are there now. You can see. Aruzu rice. Hakilna? Field. Kathiru means plenty. Kathiru? Plenty. Ya abi? Oh my father. The total meaning. Haruzu hakilna kathirun. What's meaning? Haruzu rice. Hakilna our field. Kathir plenty or more. How can say that? Total. There is plenty rice in our field. Haruzu hakilna kathirun. There is plenty. There is plenty rice in our field. Ya abi, oh my father. Haruzu hakilna. There is plenty rice in our field. Ya abi, oh my father. Next, alhamdulillah. What's meaning alhamdulillah? Thanks God, praise to God. Alhamdulillah, praise to God. Students, please write the meanings. That's very important. Please just note it in your notebook. Aruzu hakilna kathirun. There is plenty rice in our field. Ya abi, oh my father. Alhamdulillah. Next, alhamdulillah. Praise to God. Wa alayna means we should. Wa alayna, we should. Annashkur Allah. We should thank. We should thank Allah. We should thank Allah. Ala ni'amihi. Ala ni'amihi. On His blessing. On His grace. Okay. Once more. Alhamdulillah. Praise to God. Wa alayna. Wa alayna means we should annashkur Allah. We should thank Allah. Ala ni'amihi. On His grace. Next, you can see the some people, poor people, they are coming and asking, Assalamu alayka ya Ahmad. That old man is names is Ahmad. So they are telling salam. Assalamu alayka. Assalamu alayka ya Ahmad. What's meaning assalamu alayka? Assalamu alaykum. What's meaning assalamu alaykum? Peace be upon you. Peace be upon you. Assalamu alayka ya Ahmad. Oh Ahmad, assalamu alayka. Assalamu alayka, that's meaning peace be upon you. Those who don't know, please write it that meaning. Assalamu alayka, peace be upon you ya Ahmad. Oh Ahmad, peace be upon you. Wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Old man, his reply. Wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. He replied, Wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Same meaning, peace be upon you. Peace be upon you. Wa rahmatullah means rahmat, kindness. Wa barakatuh. Wa barakatuh, that's meaning prosperity. So total meaning, you can write, peace be upon you. Assalamu alayka ya Ahmad. O Ahmad, peace be upon you. Wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Peace be upon you. And kindness of Allah and prosperity. Same meaning, peace be upon you. That's enough. Next, that poor people, they are asking, Hal tu utina min zakat? Hal tu utina min zakat? What's meaning? Hal tu utina, can you give us? Can you give us min zakat? From zakat. Zakat, you know, charity, zakat. So, Hal tu utina min zakat? O Ahmad, can you give us? Can you give us zakat from zakat? Poor people is asking. They are asking, Hal tu'tina min zakat? Can you give us zakat? The Ahmad, that rich man, that old man, Naam, Naam, he replied, Naam, yes, az-zakatu hakkukun, az-zakatu, zakat hakkukun. That's your property. That's your right. That's your right. Naam, yes, az-zakatu, zakat hakkukum. That's your property. That's your right. Okay. Next page, you can see the one, his son, the old man, his son asking, Limada nu'tihim kulla hadha ya walidi. Limada nu'tihim kulla hadha ya walidi. He's asking what? Limada ni. Limada means why. Limada, why. Nu'tihim kulla hadha. Why you are giving this all, oh my father? Limada nu'tihim kulla hadha. Limada nu'tihim. Why you are giving this all? Kulla means this all. Kulla hadha, this all. Limada nu'tihim kulla hadha. Why you are giving this all? Ya walidi, oh my father. Why you are giving this all? That time, that father, he replied, Allah, Allah, yubarikulana, Allah will give barakats. Allah will give barakats. Yubarikulana, Allah will give barakat us bihadi zakat. With this zakat, Allah yubarikulana, Allah will give us barakats. Barakat means prosperity. Allah will give prosperity bihadi zakat, with this zakat. Wal bakhilu la barakata lahu indahu. Wal bakhil means stingy. Stingy means close-fisted man. Close-fisted man we can call stingy. Okay. Al bakhilu, close-fisted, those who don't have wish to give charity. Okay. We can call them close-fisted or stingy. Wal bakhilu, stingy, la barakata lahu indahu. La barakata indahu. In front of Allah, la barakatalahu, no prosperity. Wal bakhilu, stingy, close-fisted man, la barakatalahu, he has no prosperity, indahu, in front of Allah. Once more, limada nu'tihim kulla hadha ya walidi. One son, he is asking, oh father, why you are giving this all? Allah yubariku lana bihadi is zakat. Allah will give barakat with this zakat. Wal bakhilu la barakata lahu indahu. Stingy, he has no barakat. He has no prosperity in front of Allah. Next picture. Khudu means that old man, he's telling. Khudu, please take. Khudu means please take. Please take. Wahada hakkukun. This your property. This your what? Right. This your right. Khudu. Please take. Khudu. Please take. Hada hakkukun. This is your right. Next one. Ba'da mautil walid toyibi. Ba'da mautil walid toyibi means, mouth means death. Mouth, death. Ba'da means after. Walid, father. Toyib means good. So total meaning, by the mawtil walidi tayyibi, after the death of good father, that good father, after a long time, that old man, he passed away. By the mawtil walidi tayyibi, after the death of that good father, meaning by the mawtil walidi tayyibi, after the death of that good father, two sons, they are talking each other. What? Odan. Odan means tomorrow. Odan, tomorrow, Yom al Hasad. Yom al Hasad means Yom day. Al Hasad, harvesting day. Yom al Hasad. Hasad means harvest. So we can harvest in field, you know. So Odan, tomorrow, Yom al Hasad. Tomorrow, day of harvesting. Day of harvest. Yom al Hasad, harvest. Fahal sanukhriju zakata. فَلْنُخْرِجُ الزَّكَاةَ كَمَا كَانَ يَفْعَلُ وَالِدُنَا فَلْسَنُخْرِجُ الزَّكَاةَ. We want to give zakat. فَلْسَنُخْرِجُ الزَّكَاةَ. We want to give zakat. كَمَا كَانَ يَفْعَلُ وَالِدُنَا كَمَا كَانَ يَفْعَلُ وَالِدُنَا. As our father did. We want to pay zakat. We want to give zakat. Tomorrow is the day of harvest. We want to give zakat as our father did. Other son, he said, La means no. Wa nahnu means we. Ahakku bi aruzina. We have more right. Okay, we have more right to this rice. Wa nahnu ahakku bi aruzina. That is our right. La, no. Wa nahnu ahakku bi aruzina. That is our right. One son, he asked, why? Tomorrow is the harvest day. We want to pay zakat, we want to give zakat as our father did. Then other son, he replied, no need of that. That's our right. Next, walakin al fuqaraa sayakhdhuruna ghadan. One son, he telling what? Walakinna means but. Al fuqaraa means fakir, fuqaraa, poor people. Sayakhdhuruna ghadan. But poor people, tomorrow is a harvest day, no? But poor people, sayaghdhuruna means They will come. Ghadan means tomorrow. Once more, walakinna, but al-fuqara'a, poor people, sayaghdhuruna ghadan, they will come ghadan tomorrow. Then next, nadhhabu. Other son, he replied, nadhhabu. We can go. Ilal hikl nadhhabu means we can go. Ilal hikl. Hikl means hikl. We studied first field. Ilal hikl, to the field. Laylan means at night. When nadhhabu, we can go. Ilal hakl, to the field. Laylan, at night. Wanahsudu, then we can harvest. Wanahsudu, we can harvest al arza, rice. Qabla an yahduru, before they come, we can harvest. We can go to the field and we can harvest. Once more, walakin al fuqara'a sayahduruna, then but poor people, they will come tomorrow. Nadhhabu ila al aqil laylan, other son, he replied, nadhhabu ila al aqil, we can go to the field laylan, at night. Wa nahsudu, we can harvest al arza, rice. Qabla an yahduru, before they come. Next, asri' qabla an yastaiqil al-fuqara. A son, he is advising his brother, asri', then be hurry. We can go to the field before the poor people come. So asri' means be hurry. Qabla an yastaiqil al-fuqara, qabla an yastaiqil al-fuqara, qabla an yastaiqil al-fuqara means before they wake up. They means Poor people wake up. Asriq bi hari qabla an yastaiqil al fuqara, before the poor people wake up. Next, sanahsudu al aruza, we can harvest rice. Sanahsudu, we can harvest al aruza, rice. Qabla sabah, before morning, we can go to night and we can complete the harvest before the morning. Sanahsudu, we can harvest al aruza, rice. Qabla sabah, before the morning. Walam yarana fuqaraha, then walam yarana al fuqaraa, then poor people, they will not see us. Walan yaran al fuqaraa, they will not see us. Sana sudul aruza qabla sabah, we can complete our harvest qabla sabah, before the morning. Walan yaran al fuqaraa, then poor people, they will not see us. Next page, you can see there that scoundrels, that's two sons, they went to their field, but Their field catch fire. So we can read al ashqiyahu, that's scoundrels. Scoundrel means bad people, bad son, failures. Scoundrels, yadhhabuna ila al-akl, they went to their field. Yadhhabuna, they went ila al-hikl. Hikl means ila al-hakl. Hakl means to the field. Laylan, at night. Ila al-hakl laylan, to their field laylan, at night. Al-ashqiyau, the scoundrels, yadhhabuna ila al-akl, they went to their field laylan, at night, but their field catch fire. Then one son, he's telling, ya ilahi, oh my god, mahada what is this, madha hadatha li hakilina, what happened to our field. Madha hadatha li hakilina means what happened to our field. Madha hadatha li hakilina, what happened to our field. Hada jazauna, aradina an nahrim al fuqara min al zakat. That same son, he's telling, hada jazauna, this is punishment. Hada jazauna, this is punishment from Allah. Aradina, hada jazauna means this is punishment. Aradina means we think an nahrima means to prevent. An nahrima, to prevent. Whom al fuqara'a, fuqara means fuqara, poor people, min az-zakat, from zakat. Hada jazauna, this is punishment from Allah. Aradina, we think أن نحرم الفقراء أن نحرم to prevent الفقراء poor people from من الزكاة. من الزكاة means from زكاة. Total meaning this is punishment we think to prevent poor people from zakat. That's why Allah he punished us. That time his brother said, Aina dhahab al-aruzu, where is rice? Where is rice? Aina dhahab al-aruzu, where is rice? Lakad halakat al-ashjar. Lakad halakat. Lakad halakat means destroyed. Al-ashjar plants. All plants destroyed. All plants destroyed. Once more, Aina dhahab al-aruzu, where is rice? Where is our rice? Lakad halakat al-ashjar. All plants destroyed. That same son, he is telling, لَكَدْ حَلَكْنَا, we destroyed, we spoiled, we destroyed, لَيْتَنَا, لَكَدْ حَلَكْنَا, we destroyed, لَيْتَنَا أَعْطَيْنَاهُمْ حَكَّهُمْ مِثْلَ وَالِدِنَا, we had given the right, as our father, our field may not catch fire. Next picture, لَكَدْ إِنْتَكَمَ اللَّهُ, Allah punished us. لَكَدْ إِنْتَكَمَ Allah. Allah punished us. جَزَاءً بُخْلَنَا, for our miserliness, for our closed fisted, for our miserliness. لَكَدْ إِنْتَكَمَ Allah. Allah is punished, revenged to us. جَزَاءً بُخْلَنَا, for our miserliness. نعم, he said, نعم, yes. لَكَدْ أَصْبَعِنَا فُقَرَى, we became poor. نعم, yes, لَكَدْ أَصْبَحْنَا فُقَرَى, we became poor. اللهم, next picture, they are praying to God for their bad deeds. اللهم, Allah, اغفر لنا, forgive us, وَعَتِنَا, please give us, وَلَنْ نَحْرِمَ الْفُقَرَاءَ, we will not prevent poor. Once more, Allahumma Allah, اغفر لنا, please forgive us, وعتنا, please give us, ولن نحرم, we will not prevent الفقراء, poor. الزكاة will give barakat, will give prosperity, fil mali, in the money, in the wealth, وتزيده, that will increase our money. الزكاة, زكاة فعلا, actually, تبارك will give barakat في المال, in our wealth, in our money, وتزيدو, that will increase our money. Now we are going to wind up our class. Everyone has understood today's class. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. I will clear your doubts, inshallah. Have a nice day. Assalamu alaikum.